then it happened.
I can't get no help in here. I got to lead this deck. But watch this. It's not your own. See, when David looks back to the Goliath, even though God fought with him, all he can see is that he was the victor. And so when you look back at what God has brought you from, all you see is, child, I made it through that with three kids. And if I did that, I can make it. Now, you didn't see the fact that it wasn't you with three kids, but it was the grace of God. It wasn't you that escaped the divorce. It wasn't you that made it out of jail when they had the car charges against you. It was the grace of God. See, but when you relive the story, all what you've done, and so your confidence is in you. And guess what? In this level of what God has to do, it can't be in you. It's got to be in him. So watch what he does in the text. He transitions his confidence in his own consciousness, because as long as he's conscious of his own confidence, he now nullifies the power of God to be conscious in this particular element which he's in. And so what he does now is that he switches it. Instead of encouraging David, he encourages David in the Lord. In other words, it ain't me that's got to fight this battle. When he got ready to do the other battle, it was David. But this battle, guess what? It's going to take God. Get this. You don't even know where the enemy is. He calls, contacts the third man, and he begins to look, and he says, God, what shall we do? And God gives him the word and says, pursue after your enemy. You got to understand that when he encourages himself, now he's got to encourage his men. Listen to me, brothers and sisters. It ain't enough just for you to encourage yourself. It ain't enough for you to get excited and get happy about the victory of God. Comes a time in your life, you got to grab the people that's in the same predicament you in and say, come on, brother, come on, come on, come on, brother, we can do this. Come on, brother, we can do this. It may be difficult on yesterday, but we can do this. Grab Samantha the sorrowful. Grab James the depressed. Grab Sister Dinky Bell that don't never believe anything and tell her, baby, it may not look good, but with God, all things are possible. You got to encourage somebody on your block. You got to find somebody that's been in the same condition you in and tell them better days are on the way. You got to look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I understand we may be in the same predicament. You may be looking at foreclosure and I may be looking at it too. But the God I serve is able. He's our present help in the time of trouble. David said, I was young, but now I'm old, but never have I seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed beckon for bread. You got to encourage. David got encouraged and encouraged his men. He said, let shall we pursue? And the Lord said, you shall. And guess what? The Bible says David left that place. I like when David leaves the place. If you're going to get victory, you got to leave the place you in. Even David didn't know where he was going, but he went somewhere. One of the greatest things, I hear people say, I want a job. You got to get from where you are and go looking for a job. Searching on the internet only, use a fool. You got to diversify yourself. Knock on somebody's door. You'll be there when they open the door and say, mister, I need a job. Lay your pride on the table for 33 seconds and say, hey, what do you got in here I can do? If you walk better, you got to do better. If what you're doing ain't working, try something else. Stop using certain remedies of old-fashioned fables and thoughts to be your excavation to the next level that God has for you in life. Say, I got to do something different to get something better. I got to try something different to get a different connection, a different work. So what if you've been singing on three programs? Diversify, sing on six. You got to do better, do more, diversify yourself. If you've done it this way, do it a different way. But so what? I know how to do this way. You know why we don't like change? Because change presses us outside of our comfort zone. Change means I got to do what I've never done. Change means I got to depend on folks. And I don't like to depend on folks. I've been there myself. You better hear what I'm trying to say. God has to push you beyond your level of comfort. He has to push you beyond what you like. He has to take you to the era that you've never gone before. So he knows that he can bring in you what he needs to bring. And so David leaves from where he is. They said, where you going, David? David said, I'm going where the Lord sends me. I don't know where I'm going right now in my life. I don't even know what I'm doing right now in my life, but I know I got to get up out of where I am right now. David leaves and he gets down the road pursuing, but he meets an enemy. You got to watch this. He meets a symbol of the enemy. What the enemy had did is they had left one of the men back. You've got to be careful. Let me deal with this text and get on out of here. The enemy that he was chasing, because a man got injured, they left him. You got to be careful when you're wicked that you don't leave any luggage behind you. Watch this. They leave the enemy, and the enemy says, if you don't kill us, we'll tell you where the enemy is. Look here, God always has a ram in the bush, even in the midst of your
your greatest hour. Your enemy may be out of sight and out of mind, but guess what? Because no place is hid from God. God will reveal it. And the enemy said unto them, the enemy says to him, he said, they're going yet yonder. If you go here, these are their plans, and this is the next place. The Bible said that David caught them and slew them from the rising of that day to the going down of the next. You got to understand something, that when the Spirit of God is on you, your enemy can stay where they are. They may be comfortable where they are, but they won't last long. And the Bible said that the Spirit of the Lord came upon David, and they recovered all. And what I come to tell you tonight is that though your enemy be in your light, don't be afraid to encourage yourself. So what, the cards have been against you? So what, the devil said you couldn't make it? There comes a time in your life where you got to encourage yourself. Tell yourself, with God, all things are possible. I just feel my hip. You got to tell your devil that's in your life. You may have won the last victory. You may have won the last battle, but I got the war, and I read the word, and it says I'm a winner. Shall we pursue? Yes, we will. Well, Lord, I lost my job. Shall we pursue? Yes, I shall. My marriage is on the rocks. Shall we pursue? I'm broke and ain't got no money. Shall I pursue? They got my Abigail. Shall I pursue? Shall I die right here? Shall I sing a long song? DJ, play it one more time. I got a feeling that everything is gonna be all right. So what? I shall mount up with wings as an eagle. I shall run and not be weary. This too shall pass in my life. Tell the devil, I got to get my stuff. I got to get my joy. I used to be happy. I used to be married. I used to be whole. I used to be a baller. I want my stuff. Slap somebody and said, I got to have it.
Your neighbor said, I gotta have it. Look at your neighbor and say, I got to have it. Look at your neighbor and say, I got to have it. Tell them, eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard, but I gotta have it. Gotta have it. Tell somebody to recover all. Recover all. Comes a time in your life